this leads.
As the alcove opens up, Yuki's leaning
but ask
ah! No!
Oh, it's you. I must admit I'm surprised. Why, it's a face that I could then-
The skeleton grabs the corpse by-
Because my-
You are- So, if I'm to traverse this land, I will need a mask to disguise my features.
Oh, please.
No, and then, at least from this realm.
A cu-
I could- We stuck, but I will find them. Well, that several. I was. Perhaps I should thank.
Ah,
every. Perhaps. Regardless, I suppose. You seem excellent. While we are conversing. Of course, the arcane arts are my little speciality. But being a Brit. Ah, you seek a more. I could do that with one hand behind. Splendid. Very well.
Did you see them, sir? Bishop Alexander and the hammer herself, they were so close, almost within arm's reach. You don't know them? Oh, remarkable. Bishop Alexander is the son of the Divine, the leader of the Divine Order. And Dallas, that they are all that stand between you, me, and the Void. And they were right here just a moment ago, attending to some business. for my protection, sir. And for your protection, and for the protection of all the realm. Don't you see that?
Come on then, Lexi. Hey up.
I find I need bread. I want no trouble.
Bread or a brisket, toll's the same.
Your griff teaches you to bully others. Pathetic.
You keep his name out of your mouth, you filthy cunt-chewer.
Have you, cud?
Disgusting, just like all your kind.
Disgusting like theft? Disgusting like threats?
Right, God, will you quit dragging this on? Take that on, Lexi. Just hand over the gold.
I will not. This is not your business, Long Pig.
Don't let this moss muncher talk to you like that. Especially a cheapskate like this one. Griff already knows she don't like to pay her fair share. Pay up, Elf. No one shorts Griff. Especially not one of you. Runs the kitchen. Means he runs me, you, and everyone else in camp. Everyone in camp's got to contribute. For food, for protection. No exceptions. Especially not for elves.
Food? Protection? I have neither.
You two ought to be thanking your lucky gods it's us, and not the Magisters enforcing round here. A fool, never know. Now come on, Elf. If you make me say it again, there's gonna be trouble.
Why, yes. Of course I am. All my life.
Elodie? Oldwood? Impaler?
He shifts uncomfortably.
Get out of here, will ya? You ain't worth my time, neither are ya.
The elf smiles and bows to you in thanks.
Follow me, before more of them trouble us. There is a safe place.
You gonna pray all day, buddy?
From the den outside.
Thank you for your help with that thug. Rare is the human who goes against their own for an elf.
She smiles, warily.
I won't forget your aid, friend. Perhaps I can be of aid to you. It gives me great pain. I'm with my family. We are making beautiful magic. We are healing a tree cut down with great violence. The Magisters come. My family runs, but I fall. In this cave, we trust the healer. She is young, but she sees. She knows more than we know. In the camp, the brute Griff rules. He who gives the bread has the power. I hear of no escapes. The only way out is through. Through the Magisters, through their cure. Thugs, I can stand, but I fear the Magisters. Wait, before you go. I am not here without your help. I do not forget this. For you, a prize. I save it for a special occasion, but I can think of no finer occasion than this. Thank you.
You can't get me!
I feel him, but I do not see him.
Whoever kills the other is the boss! Sure, sure, sure! Got you! I feel him, but I do not see him.
You're too slow! You're cheating!
I feel him. I feel him, but I do not see him.
You're too slow! You can't get me!
I know they help. I know they help.
Whoever kills the other is the boss. You can't get me.
Whoever kills the other is the boss! Sure, sure, sure! Got you!
I know they help.
You're too slow! Wait, I call a timeout!
Thank you.
Shua! Got you!
Thank you for your help with that, thug. No doubt he turns on you next. These humans hate us. To be vulnerable in a place like this is tough. You may keep your shame for yourself. And oh, it is not wrong to walk in the camp. It is wrong to assault one walking. You walk among the humans too long if you think differently.
Got you! I got you!
But I do not see him.
You can't get me!
I feel him, but I do not see him.
The young girl's eyes are covered, but she turns toward you when you approach. She smiles as though she recognizes you.
Ah, hello. Quite the blood-soaked journey has led you here. You are not who you once were, and I sense you are not yet who you will be.
I see it before my eyes.
Wary all of a sudden, she takes a step back from you.
I cannot offer you much more than my sympathies. Our fates are intertwined, yours and mine. This clouds my vision.
Yes, please ask. Oh, I do not cover my eyes. I cover the place they used to be. They are gone now, taken. But I see all the same. It is safer here. We make no trouble for Griff. He makes no trouble for us. My home is far. Your language gives me some trouble. We elves... Time, for us, is now. He is a very blind man. He sees things, but not truth. Not love or joy. I feel very sorry for him. You understand when you meet him. After you escape.
Thank you.
Her eyebrows shoot up.
There can be a way. Amiro knows. But he is gone. Do you see him? He knows how to leave. My protector, my friend. An elf like me, with a spirit bright as new leaves. He tries to help me, to save me, and he suffers very much. He is caught by those who hurt him. I wish so much for his return. And he tells you what you bring me great peace. Thank you, my friend. I miss him very much. I see something that helps. I see a lizard. He is a lizard of many dreams, of far feeling. You do not free Amiro without him.
Yes. Is it an audience you desire?
No one tells me there are so many children in this Fort Joy. Your kind I handle, but small ones. You know what they do? They play a game called Scream. In this game, they see who screams the loudest. I feel the Divine's loss so sharp.
No, I'm a lizard. I just didn't grow my scales yet. Yes, you were. Now get, human. Stupid human.
Whack! Back, evil ogre, or I'll get you with my sword! I'll spare you this time, beast, but don't cross me again, ever! You're really fun. Hey, I'm gonna hide somewhere in the cave, and you come find me. Ready? Go!
Huh! You are in the wrong place, Pinky. Military, are you? Be at ease here, and well met. Let me know if you need any armaments. I offer them to a fellow serviceman at a few coins discount.
The soldier stands to attention. The soldier stands to attention. The soldier stands to attention. Thank you.
friend would really, really, really like you. Come on, I'll introduce you. I know how to spell introduce. It's introduce. My way is too small for you. You'll have to find another. Hope you brought a shovel.
I've spotted something. I need a shovel.
One must put in due effort if one is to reap the proper reward.
This hole is too small for you to squeeze into.
A lot.
Please, small child, leave me to my ruminations.
But he's really nice and tall. Maybe he can even help you with that thing.
Why? A grown friend? You've brought an adult here. Good. Good gods. Can it be?
You're back! And you brought... But who's this?
It's stuck fast. Rubbish.
You! Tell me true! Stand you with the Source Hunters, or do you serve the tyrant Brachus Rex? It hasn't. The Wicked King? He's dead? Strange to think it's been so long since I've been trapped here. So long since I've seen a living soul. A child may technically be alive, but so is a potato, if you understand me. No, Morty cannot help with what I ask. A wicked king, it was. Brachus Rex by name. The Order of the Source Hunters discovered a great horror upon this prison isle, and I was sent to stop it. Yet my failure was absolute. I am not fit to bear the insignia of the Source Hunters any longer. Please, good sir, you must free me. Prize this spear from my chest, where it has been stuck fast for the last 1,000 years. Seize the spear. End this degradation.
So, what did you and Wither talk about? Yeah, I know. Why do you think I brought you down here? I want you to help him. Grown-ups are weird.
Stuck fast. Stuck fast. Stuck fast.
It's stuck fast.
I got it.
Good sir. You've set my body free. Free to crumble to dust at last. But my spirit... blast! I remain trapped in this mouldering skeleton yet. I have heard of such magic, but have never known anyone so foul as to employ it. Bracchus Rex. May maggots lace his entrails. After he interred me in this cell, he must have drawn my very soul away from me and stored it elsewhere in the fort. Thus, he has bound me entirely to the mundane realm. But I know this place well. I could lead you to its likely location. In turn, you would find a path straight out of this fort. My freedom for yours. Marvelous, my friend. Marvelous. You'll first have to get inside the fort itself. There's a secret switch on a statue of the Seven in the courtyard. Surely you know it. The switch will open a hatch, and you'll be led into the prison's main floor. I suspect that within Bracchus's phylactery room, you will find the container which ensnares my soul. He has likely disguised it well, but search there for another hidden switch. Bracchus would have made me a supplicant, a slave to these walls. With your help, I'll die. At last. Fort Joy is a dangerous place, my friend. Dangerous indeed. Bracchus used this place to build an arsenal of terrible weaponry as yet unseen in our world. Here, he and his researchers crafted punishments and snares contrary to human dignity. Objects that could contain souls, wands that could purge the very essence from sorcerers. My order would never have used such barbaric. I was fully briefed about this awful place before I came. My goal was to destroy the fiend who had been marshalling the world's most unwholesome weapons and magic into an army he intended to use against the realm. I never thought I would become one of his victims. And yet, here I am.
Like you. You're a real hero, not only one from a story. You finished your quest. Here, take this. It'll show you how to find my secret fort and my treasure. If you can find a way up, you can have my treasure.
my unlikely friend. What do you need?
I hear of no escapes. The only way out is through. Through the Magisters, through their...
Something isn't right here. Could be an ambush. Thank you.
Thank you. hurts.
I am glad to see you. Yes, please ask. I knew we must be here. I am not sure how much to explain. You are here, and so we are here.
Yourself to the grave. Frightfully busy at the moment, love. Haven't got any liquor on hand, have you? This fella could use a little comfort. Why, look at that. just what I ordered. Ain't you a peach, love? And old Deed here would thank you too if he could. Poor fella over there crossed one of Griff's card sharks and got a club to the skull. Doomed to be sure, but I'd like to ease his way out. Lucky you came out of it at all. Plenty of folks around of here haven't, and it's me who ends up wrist deep in the gore.
The man sleeps so deeply, he might as well be dead to the world.
Is that thing eating corpses?
The creature heaves through lips gummed with human gore. It turns to you with great effort, pain apparent in every movement, and madness screams from its wide, bloodshot eyes.
You. Quite lost. Careful, or they'll cross your wires. Now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? Quickly now, for I haven't much time. Maybe I unscrew your lid and poke about inside and set your memory straight. Would that please you? Can you not remember now? Where does the yarrow grow? Where?
I will yield to none.
The creature heaves through lip.
You now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? You want to leave? You want to go? Tell me where the yarrow grows. Tell me now, or shall I pick your parts clean too? It's easy. word!
The creature heaves through
You. Quite lost.
The creature heaves through
You. Now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? Maybe I unscrew your lid and poke about inside and set your memory straight. Would that please you? Can you not remember now? Are you mad? Yarrow loves the beach. Yarrow loves the sand.
Don't you think? You should be happy for Greed.
What did you say?
That's what happened, isn't it?
Bleeding snake.
Please, excuse us.
You're talking to me, not him, Sam.
Oh, for the love of Lucien, Balladeer. You're acting like a madman.
Say it again. What you said about my wife. Go on. Piss off. Go on, Sam.
Well, it's the truth, and you know it. She's better off. So what if it was messy? I'd rather puke myself to death 1,000 times than let the Reds get to me. If she were my wife, I'd be happy for her.
A flat smile twitches across Balladeer's lips.
She never did like you.
The man looks for a moment at the corpse at his feet, then turns back toward the nearly finished coffin, bloodied hammer in hand.
Murder's a big word. And no, this here's a bed for someone 1,000 times better than that snake. Rest her soul. The love of my life. Gret. She passed in the night. Something in the stomach.
He tenderly runs a hand along the coffin's side panel.
If she were here, she'd tell me this plank is crooked. Chastise me for using warped wood on her final bed. Then she'd laugh and kiss me. Just here.
The man holds a hand to his cheek for a moment. He turns from you, lines up another nail, and...
Wouldn't know a thing about you and I, Gretty.
The creature heaves through lips gummed with human gore.
You. Quite lost. Quite now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? Quick!
The creature gingerly takes the plant into his bloodied hands. He runs his fingertips over the white flowers. His panting breath slows.
Darling, dear. Dear, darling child. Hello. Yarrow girl, can it really be you?
The creature begins to weep. Fast, silent tears spill from his eyes as he clutches the little cluster of flowers to his heart.
For you, my ring, part of me, name of Migo. Thank you. Pretty, pretty, pretty. It's been too long, my dear. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Yarrow girl, you've grown, you have.
Junk.
What is it? Go. Name of Migo. Come out of Arx. My daughter's a magister. Pretty-haired yarrow girl. She doesn't know about all this, though. Don't you dare blame her, pretty-haired yarrow girl. Told you, didn't I? They crossed my wires, hammer goes clang, and then the worms crawl in. Clang, clang! Horrible old sadist. Filled my...
You there. You've just arrived, isn't that right? Are you quite alone?
Oh, very droll. Listen up. You must think me mad to approach a stranger, but this camp is full of cowards, and I'm running out of time. Fast. Too fast. Way too fast. You would be too if you'd been here as long as I have. In fact, you should be nervous if you're here at all. I know what they have planned for us. I've been here a long time. Longer than anyone else. People get taken sometimes. I have a way out of here. It won't be easy, and I need a partner. Just one. Are you interested? Oh, noble. But after the magisters take you all, your nobility will have been for nothing. Good luck with your friends, though.
What of it?
Yeah.
A little respect for Griff's right hand, Topsy.
Don't disturb me again, unless you've seen me go. You have seen him? Tell me, where was he? And you're very sure it was him? How do you know?
She inspects the ring closely.
This can't be. You said he was upon the beach, yes? I need to have a look myself. This simply can't be.
More right hands than an octopus. That's it. I call court. Pay up.
Huh? What are you doing here? Thought Griff had you making the rounds inside. Lucky you. See you later, Christoph.
Keep hunting, Wolfie.
What are you after, Pipsqueak? Complain to Griff if you don't like it. See how long you keep your ears stuck to your head.
You know, now that I think about it, Christoph was got rid of last week, wasn't he? Who the hell are you then? Bugger off.
I don't think I ain't watching. That's your fifth blue chest in his throat.
The woman is scrabbling at her throat, as though she can hardly breathe. As she catches sight of you, recognition flashes in her terrified eyes. She drops her hands from her throat and starts hyperventilating.
Ben, Mest! Ifan! Ben, Mest! You killed them! You killed them! He killed them all! Murderer!
That's it. I call court. Pay out.
Keep him away from me! Help! Somebody! Keep him away!
Stay back. Stay back! Keep that monster, Ben Mest, away from me!
Watching. That's your fifth blue jester this round.
What of it?
Yeah, what of it?
As you approach the blacksmith, you feel a bony hand on your arm. Fane leans in and whispers in your ear.
If it would be acceptable, I have an inquiry for this human. It is of a personal nature. And if it would not be acceptable, well, that would render this entire conversation rather awkward.
Fane approaches the blacksmith and quietly speaks to her. You can't overhear much, but he seems to be gesturing towards her head an awful lot. Fane's words are quiet, but you hear the blacksmith repeat, "Face Ripper," in shock. She slowly starts to back away.
What is it with creeps like you and Master Niles? I told him to slither back to his dungeon, and you can get too, freak!
Fane backs away, scratching his head. It seems that didn't go as he'd expected. He is lost in thought, though. She must have said something he found interesting. Amidst a crowd of screws, bolts, and scraps of metal, the woman is manipulating a glove-like contraption fitted with five long metal skewers. She...
And what you after? Get bent!
A grin cracks her stony face.
Sure thing.
Thank you.
Thank you.